the files.
Amen.
Don't you know this? I mean, it happens.
Oh, yeah.
Angels can take money and deposit in your account.
Amen.
You don't even know what angels do. Angels can take money and deposit in your account. And before you know it, money just appear. Angels, you need to put them to work. They are ready to back up the word of God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We have angels.
Amen.
They are not God. We don't worship them. But they are to minister to us.
Hallelujah.
They are our servants.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The next one is, I'm rounding up because Pastor said that all what we have learned from last week, we have to demonstrate it next week.
Amen.
Come ready. I said, do what? Come ready. You have to demonstrate what you have learned. Don't come alone. I want you to tell every member of this church
Amen.
That Sunday they don't have to fail.
Amen.
Then bring people, bring the sick, bring people with challenges.
Amen.
We want to exercise the authority that has been given to us.
Amen.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Glory.
And the next one is anointing. That's number five. God has given you anointing. Yes, I understand that anointing comes by measure. Everything he has given us, he gives us by measure. Yeah. So what are you doing with the measure he has measured to you?
Mm.
No matter how small it is, what are you doing with the anointing he has given you? If you are faithful for little, he will increase it.
Amen.
Are you understanding me?
Hallelujah.
If you are faithful for little, he will do what? He will increase it. I used to ask myself, why is it the anointing increase in crusade? No, because much demand is needed in crusade. You see, our pastor like this, you are taking this man for granted. I wish one day you follow him to a crusade. You come and say, I don't think pastor was in another level. No, because at that time, God needs to do something. He now troubles for a reason and for a season.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
I never appreciated the anointing in my life until when I went to Moyoka. Let me tell you, this is true. I went to Moyoka. I was preaching. And it got to a level, pastors were going down to lay hands. I said, pastors, hold on, hold your peace, it's not time. They came back. When I finished, I told them to go pray. In my heart, I didn't want to go because I did not trust myself. I said, if I go, nothing will happen. So let them go. Consciously, I did that. I stayed in the book. They went. They were praying. There was power. There was manifestation. I did not go. When they finished, something said, okay, just congratulate the people. And I said, hey, come, let me congratulate you for what the Lord has done. Ignorantly, not knowing. When I sent my hand, the power came. I sent my hand, the first one fell. The second one fell, the third one fell. And then I thought I was powerful. The moment flesh jumped in, I thought I was powerful. I sent my hand, that flow stopped. Nothing happened again. I said, I thought I know this thing. The Holy Spirit said, you don't know nothing. It's not you. It's me.
Amen.
And I stood at the platform. I look at the lady and say, from the crown of your head down to the sole of your feet, every sickness. As I hear the Lord saying that there is a sickness called sickness unto death, but we can reverse that situation. There's a deadly virus in your system. I said, from the crown of your head down to the sole of your feet, we cleanse you up. While I was saying, I didn't know who I was talking to. I was just saying, the power of God took that sister. I have that in a video. She fell down, and they went to catch her. I said, better don't go closer, because she was like rocking. Wow, she went under the table, scattered the whole musical instrument. Then I came back, I said, so I have anointing, I did not know. You are sitting there like that, you are so anointed, but you don't know it. I told you that authority can only be exercised when you are faced with a crisis, when you are faced with challenges, when demons frighten you, when demons challenge you. That's when you have to exercise your authority.
Amen.
And it's in you. You don't have to feel it.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit was with you before you said yes to Jesus. Are you understanding me?
Amen.
Now when you said yes, the Holy Spirit now is in you. He's with you when you were about to say yes. He was with you. Now, when you said yes, you welcome Jesus, you welcome His Spirit, He is in you. But the other level, the third level called upon you, that one doesn't come anyhow.
Jesus.
It comes for a reason.
Amen.
And for a season.
Amen.
It comes as an impartation that when a man of God is preaching, when a child of God is preaching, there is something that comes unto you that gives you boldness. At that time, it is not you. That is the time that mirror short season after that it goes. And that's why you see some preachers, when it comes, they are in a haste to do whatever, because they don't know how long it will last. Amen. So they hurry, and do as much as they can before the anointing leaves. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Every believer is a receptacle of that anointing.
Hallelujah.
When you prepare your mind, prepare your heart, just be a receptacle. At any time, God can bring the anointing upon you. Amen. He said, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Hallelujah. And the young shall see visions. Yes. The old shall dream dreams. Why would the young see visions? Because you have all the potential to achieve what God has given you. Amen. What is a vision? A vision is like a blueprint of the plan that God has for your life and your future. And so God gives you a vision. Now it's only a vision, but you have to also write your vision. Amen. When you write your vision, you start to announce your vision. Amen. When you announce your vision, you start to do something. Look, yesterday that lady launched her album. It was only a thought. At first, it was only a thought. That's a vision. Then when she started writing her song, now she went to the studio. Today, she's an artist.
Amen.
We are all people with lots of potentials. Potentials. You have been given those potential. And as I round up this morning, because time is not on my side, I give you the number 6 tool that Christ has given us. Prayer and fasting.
Amen.
How many of you hate prayer and fasting? You hate prayer and fasting? Does anyone hate prayer and fasting here? Please. The Bible says that humble yourself before God. Resist the devil and he will flee. That word humble is taken from fasting. Fasting is the time that you humble yourself before God.
Hallelujah.
You deny your flesh enjoyment. You deny your flesh enjoyment. You humble before God. That is when you become spiritually sensitive. You get equipped and strengthened. It is for your own good, not for the good of God.
Amen.
Fasting is required. I used to tell people that there are 3 things that we don't have choice to do. Look, when it comes to giving to God, when it comes to praying, and when it comes to fasting, in Matthew chapter 6, he said, when you give, when you fast, and when you pray. So, this is supposed to be the normal thing for every believer.
Jesus.
Don't be eating and eating and eating and eating every day. You cannot even fast for 6 hours. You can fast from 6 to 12.
Amen.
Depending what how far you can go. You can fast for the whole day. Now, Pastor is making a good arrangement for us. He's talking about we have to fast for 7 days. Some people are already saying, hi, Master, 7 days. And he said that some people can even go for 21 days, and some can go 40. To 40. Fasting is in the Bible. Jesus fasted. Moses fasted. A lot of people fasted in the Bible. Look, if you must win, if you are not winning, then you are already winning. But for you to stay on top, you must also love fasting and pray.
Amen.
I mean, you cannot run away from that. You must love it. It must become part of you. The way I make my life now, I mean, I just enjoy it. But before, it was so difficult. When I think of fasting, I think of punishment. A lot of believers think that when they announce fasting, they say, Master, this is punishment coming. It's not punishment. I used to think like that too. But right now, I so decided that there is never a month that I don't fast. Never. Depending on how I want to go. Some months I can fast 3 days, some 7 days. Well, some can go 21 days. Because as far as I know, there is fight out there. Mm. And I'm not going out there to lose. Mm. I'm going out there to win.
Amen.
Somebody praise the Lord.
Amen.
So fasting and prayer is required for you to be equipped. When Jesus said, don't go anywhere, don't do anything. Stay here until I send you the promise of the Father. What were they doing? Were they sleeping? They were praying. So when the 120 were praying, the Holy Ghost came and anointed them with power.
Hallelujah.
Power only comes when you are praying.
Amen.
When you are plowing. Praying is like to plow.
Amen.
To plow.
Amen.
Do you know when Elisha received the first anointing? As the young guy was plowing, Elisha passed and dropped his mantle over him. Before Jesus selected the 12, he went to the mountain. What is mountain? Mountain is for prayer.
Amen.
We need prayer and fasting,
Amen.
My people. We cannot do without this. Look, prayer and fasting will make you a better believer.
Hallelujah.
I'm telling you, I say it will make you a better believer. If you want to live a distinguished ordinary. They do some extraordinary things.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You want to win, you have to go the extra. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I know some churches in Africa, they go 100 days fasting.
Oh yeah.
Aye. But don't be scared. You know you can fast from 6A to 6B and then you eat, depending on your strength. But do you know you can also fast just from 6A to 12? That is still fasting.
Amen.
That is, you can make up your mind not to eat every day. You only eat after 12 when you break your fasting for 40 days. Very easy. You think you will die? You think you're going to die for not eating before 12? That's a lie from the devil.
Amen.
You see how the devil deceives us? That's a lie from the devil. If I can just eat after 12, I can go even the whole year. I won't die. After 12, you can now, the one you miss in the morning, you can put it together.
Catch up.
And catch up. A resident came to me and said, hey, I missed my 12 o'clock medicine. I said, but it's 10:30 p.m. And I said, yeah. I said, so you think the one you miss at 12, I'm responsible now? He said, yeah, just give me that one and this one. I said, I'm not giving you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So as I round up this morning, look, next week will be very, very wonderful. We are going to exercise our authority.
Amen.
But we are not just waiting for next week. Even after we leave here, we leave.